In tonight's Medical Watch, a project that's more than 20 years in the making could soon help the blind to see.
And Dina Baer shows us how the implant works and why it could be an historic breakthrough for those with vision loss.
Think of the brain as a sophisticated image processor. But when the eyes and optic nerve aren't functioning, can science bypass the obstacles? An implant developed right here in Chicago may offer hope and light to those who live in total darkness.
It looks like a workshop of sorts. Inside this Illinois Institute of Technology lab, they stitch and spin. Gold wire circles the perimeter of each device assembled here. Combined, the tiny components have big promise. They're designed to help the blind see something.
And so that's probably what we're seeing with the parallax and everything.
It's a challenge Dr. Philip Troik and his research team have been working on for 20 plus years.
We can bypass the eyes and the optic nerve and go directly to the brain.
Think of the system as a prosthesis aid for vision, implanted directly into the brain. An external camera that mounts on a pair of glasses captures an image that is then transmitted to up to 40 implanted microstimulators. The implants have multiple electrodes that stimulate neurons in the brain's vision cortex.
So what we're attempting to do is to tap into that image processor and send in signals that the brain can then interpret and then create a perception that's related to the image that comes from the camera. So you can imagine that the artificial vision would be very crude. But for a person who has no vision perception at all, it could be very useful as another visual aid.
A simulator shows what users might see.
And then you can see here these dots on that computer screen represent what the person might perceive if they had 650 implanted electrodes.
Dr. Troik started working on the project in 1996, the first human clinical trial of the intracortical visual prosthesis system, or ICVP, is set to begin in early 2022. Patients in the study will undergo a neurosurgical procedure to insert the devices into the brain.
The tool is electrically activated and a little plunger pushes it out into the brain. So that's how the implantation is done.
I think people are enthusiastic about it when they start to understand the potential.
Mary Abramson is an advocate for the study and will serve as the liaison between participants and the research team.
When I walk down this hallway, what I'm getting visually is kind of a gray slate of nothingness.
The ICVP might provide some contrast and help users spot obstacles and light along the way.
When I get to the hallway that branches off to my left, because the light will be different coming from that hallway than from the walls, I'll be able to know that it's there and to know where I am in relationship to the front desk.
Mary doesn't qualify to participate in the research herself, but she has high hopes for those who might benefit from the technology.
So in the days that I see truly nothing, just black, I feel like I'm in this little bubble. But if I could at least see light or see shapes of people around me, that's going to make me feel like I can interact with them more appropriately. And that means everything to the human being.
The research team is hoping to enroll 5 volunteers in the study. The Chicago Lighthouse will serve as the hub for monitoring and testing those who participate.
We are breaking ground, and 100 years from now, when the prosthetics are, you know, standard, we will have been a part of that history making, that groundbreaking work.
And we don't know how far this can go. We want it to be more than the E on the I chart. We eventually want it to be seeing a loved one's face. And this project is to explore the very beginnings of that, to see how we might do something that would improve the quality of life, because that's really what it's about.
I think this is a really historical event and a historical breakthrough.
Study participants must have had near normal vision as a child in order to enroll in the trial. That's because the brain's visual cortex needs to have developed to be capable of interfacing with the implantable system. Back to you.